This is adding and subtracting rational expressions, which basically means adding fractions. And in order to add fractions, we have to have common denominators. So the first two steps are going to be used to create a common denominator, or at least to locate one. So the first thing we want to do is factor the denominators. We want to find all the factors that are involved, and then we can actually write our LCD. And so remember, for our LCD and LCMs, which is our same thing, we have to take and factor them. And then we write every single type of factor that we have down. And if there is an exponent, then we pick the largest exponent. So now we have our LCD. We can now create common denominators. And if you notice, I've written them vertically. I think it's the cleanest method to use. And to make sure you always bring that minus sign to the numerator. Okay, and now we can just see what are we missing. So on the bottom, it's missing an x plus 1. So we multiply top and bottom by x plus 1. And this allows us to distribute. So we get 2x squared plus 2x minus 3x. Minus 3. And then on the bottom, it's missing an x plus 3. And so when we distribute, we get minus 2x squared minus 6x's. All right, and now that we have a common denominator, we can add or subtract. In this case, we're adding the tops. So we have 2x squared plus 2x minus 3x. And yes, you can just combine them if you want. And then now the bottom is minus 2x squared minus 6x all over our common denominator. All right, and all we have to do now is simplify. So 2x squared minus 2x squared, those cancel. We have 2x minus 3x, that's minus 1, and minus 6 gives us minus 7x. And a minus 3. All over x minus 3, x plus 3, x plus 1. And the last step is always reduce your fraction if you can, but since we cannot factor the top, we're done. That is the final answer. All right, let's try one more. So first thing to do is factor the denominators. So we have 15, and then they have a common factor of y plus 3. And then that one is factored. And same with the last one. We'll just put it in a parenthesis. And then now we write each type of factor. So we have a y and a y plus 3. That is our LCD. And then we go down. And we rewrite it for each one. Okay. So now on the top one, it's missing nothing, so we just transfer it. The second one is missing a y plus 3, so we multiply that top and bottom, which gives us 2y's plus 6, and the bottom is missing a y. And there we go. All right, now on this one, we're going to do it a little bit quicker. So if you notice, we just add the tops. That's all we did, so that's all we're going to do. You have 2y's and 5y's. That's 7y's. We have 15 and 6, that's 21, and then that's all over our common denominator of y plus 3. Alright, now of course I got to have one in there where we simplify, and the top is factorable, so we want to factor it out, the 7 that is. And there is our common factor that we can cancel. And so our answer is 7 over y. So that monstrosity of a problem right there turned into that very pretty problem. And that's why we do this. So something that's not nice is now nice. Even that one is nicer than those two together. All right. So here are 7 problems for you to try. I know that seems like a lot. So hit pause. Give them a shot. I'll do one at a time. And there's our first one. So the LCD is 12. They both have x's, so it's x squared, and then the y, So we make that our common denominator. The top one's done. The second term needs to be multiplied by a 2x. And there we go. Add them up. And there's our answer. All right. Let's try number two. So again, you want to write them vertically. Give the 1 to the top. And you need to find the common denominators. All right. And I'll give you a hint on this one. That's a parenthesis. So the LCD is not going to be x minus 3. You can't subtract top and bottom. You can only add. Hit pause and give it a shot. All right, and this is what you should have gotten. So the LCD would be x and x minus 3 together. So if we write that for our denominators, you can see the top is just missing x. The bottom is missing x minus 3. And when we distribute it, we get these two. Remember to always make that minus, give it to the numerator. And then when we combine them, 3x's take away 1x is 2x's plus 3. That's your answer. All right, give the rest of them a shot, all right, and I'll write the answer for all of them. Hit pause now and go for it. All right, and these are the answers you should have gotten, and the reason I have so many on here is I want to kind of give you every single type. So if you notice the first, they're already, that we well, number three, they're already common denominators, but you still need to distribute that negative, and then that allows us to simplify later. Number four, you notice they're opposites of each other. So if we just multiply by negative 1, it will make them into common denominators. That's our main goal for these problems, which we can then now add. This one's three terms. And if you notice now, we have three, and the other two are just factors of the third one. So we can then now add them up and give an answer. On this one, I wanted to throw in there with a square, just so you can see it. So if you do have a square, then that would be your LCD. It's p minus 2 squared. It's that one, and that one. And if you have a 4, a constant, you need to put it over 1. Well, anything that doesn't have a denominator, you'd have to put a 1 under it. All right, and then do the work, and there's your answer. You notice this one, the p minus 2 squared, I had to multiply it out. I had to FOIL it out. And then the last one is just a nice clean one, so I figured it'd be a good ending problem. So if you notice, after we multiply it, we get something that's factorable. You factor and cancel. It's a very nice, pretty problem. All right, that's everything. Thank you.